declare to the French Creoles and the English, to the new imperialists in America, the old ones in Europe, those whose anthropological instincts concerning the marvelous survival of black people makes them want to penetrate again and again into some new interior, that Pan is ours. And we declare that we who speak are most definitely African and find ourselves 10.7 degrees north latitude and 61.5 degrees west on the island of Trinidad, and that we made the Pan there and offered it to no one but our eternal exodus to freedom. We declare by the Orishas that the oil drum is Ogun's, and the machete that protects it too, and the blowtorch that rends the steel, and the hammer that pounds it into song and song into it, Ogun's. We declare Charlotte Street our beach at Normandy. We name it one of our shrines and declare that it too, seeped through with the blood of black youth, is black and Pan ours. In the name of Jit Samaru and Bugsy Sharp and Pat Bishop and Spree Simon and Ellie Manette and Anthony Williams, we declare Pan a weapon in the continued unchaining of the enslaved. We declare its composers and arrangers high priest and field marshal, and we enshrine too the yards of John John Laventille, East Dry River, and the village at Hamilton Street. In the name of all the Pans we wrapped in crocus and transported under cover of night through the Dry River, we assert the black stripe in the flag to be Pan's stripe. In the name of ghosts practicing for panorama, so as to keep our arrangement hours, our sticks, so many batty mamzels hovering over the bowl of the drum, wings rolling to disturb the air, so that the music made is the angel's chair. We declare that silence ours, and the boundary of the yard Ogun's, made of war and love at once. In the name of the 1877 band drums alchemy into hollowed out bamboo, pounded into earth to mimic goatskin, we enshrine the sound of the wind in the bamboo leaves atop groves in Carani, Aruka, Paramin, Arima, Sasusi, Valencia, Mayaro. We rebuke any narrative reducing Pan to a single bullshit story that cannot recite the verses of the African overboard to mermaids, turned into multi-melody to unchain our bodies. We reject co-optation and invoke Black Stalin's bondem on all interlopers of blackness, history, black history, and history still told by victors and false discoverers. Pan is black and ours. We remember that to be black and find ways outside the cane field to magic and thrive is, was, is illegal. And we lay the cutlass wounds, the blunt force trauma at the feet of the blameworthy European colonists, French planters fleeing Haiti, niggas aspiring to be more white than their captors and enslavers, American occupying troops anywhere such troops occupy. Any move to dull the spirits of revolution that arose from the heat, searing music and the orishas back into our skin and soil. And we pray to Saint Earl of Lovelace for his wisdom and dancing dragons to remember our blackness by. We declare Pan Black ours. We talk to the gods through the hieroglyphs of our father's scars, black skin keloiding into cowrie shell and currency. In the name of phase two pan groove and the eternal breakbeat at the center of black soul, we declare diaspora phoenix into new and shifting definitions. We declare Pan of diaspora and ours at once. We declare Pan Black and from Trinidad. We declare the theft of those oil drums righteous and saintly. We declare Pan sacred and black country, sacred and black survival, sacred and black the North Stand, sacred and black flag woman, sacred and black a hidden cutlass, sacred and black up under a base, sacred and black and Pan is a weapon and we are warriors still storming all the beaches that keep us in chains. We declare we will be free and we hold this always to be true. I drove the 15 hours to see my daughter born, to hip her to the wind that buoys sails before, presumably, I drive back. Give her bridges to cross to get to me, leave her the map by which she'd find her father. But instead, I found myself here, among the flatness and the wind-sweptness, the bitter cold and the bifurcated city, holding my ear to the ground, trying for a clatter to lease for her first dance. I've thought about being a father before all this, so I'd planned some things, picked some colors out, selected some tunes. If I'm real, I've always known it'd be a girl too. You don't spend your whole life learning how to shadowbox troubles to not have all the orishas get together and dream up one last river for you to cross. And the girl ain't the troubles, but the orishas don't bring you the war without telling you how to suit up, showing you the armor, and so it is you end up where you end up. Call it Chicago this time and call the girl Freedom. Call her Savior. Call her she who has been calling from beyond the gulf. She who has come to your dreams as the lover you couldn't place, whose face is always averted, who makes you chase her in the rain so you drive the 15 hours. From your window, you can hear grackles, cardinals, sparrows quarreling for dominance over the boulevard's early spring. And you want to wake the coughing child and tell her about the sharp, rhythmic claps that call pigeons to flamenco above Brooklyn rooftops just before sunrise. If one morning you were broken-hearted and your woman recently moved out, so you climbed the ladder up through your ceiling and onto your own roof just before the day breaks rakish into color, and laid there and cried for the pigeons, the city, the water tanks on the rooftops, the Puerto Rican hand claps like you knew you'd be leaving soon. I want to tell her what's in the 15 hours and why her papa chose the colors he comes to her in, like it'll matter to her, like she'll know better what love is, what mine wants to claim every morning I climb into the dark and come in search of her. I hadn't intended to stay. I hadn't intended to shepherd her citizenship of this place. I thought I'd teach her the names and spellings of all the bridges from here to Brooklyn and how to cross them in order she might arrive one day clutching a cigar in one hand, a machete in the other, and my name like a grip of tulips from her throat. But you don't drive 808 miles alone without being transformed, without devising whole new schemes and reasons for why you're making the trip, even 2 hours outside the destination. You'd better, if you hope to reach the new place, equipped for the bullshit a city tries to learn you while you're searching for its dance floors and seances, its black folk and soul food, its bass in the basements you want to blue light your ribcage through. But that's how you leave a city. Pile a van high with things given you with kisses, so high you can't see out the back window, and take them 15 hours to some place you won't be recognized until a girl comes screaming into the world and looks immediately for your chest, who coos into the songs you've been saving for her. Say it like this, like the old people have told you for years. What hasn't met you hasn't passed you. You'll understand that even as the principle of the sound coming back around the same groove of the same turntable whose needle hiccups imperceptibly at the moment that was once smooth, you're grateful for that hitch in your step, for the thunder of pigeon's wings. What to do, Washington, D.C.? Welcome to Miyamoto is Black Enough. On cello, you have Jeffrey Ziegler. On pan and composition, you have Andy Akiho. My name is Roger Bonnier-Agar. These are poems, musings, writings from a couple of different iterations of myself. And on drums, please give it up for Sean Dixon. Nina. The bodega used to be a grocery store. The liquor store used to be a pizza parlor. This cafe used to be an Italian restaurant. That kiosk used to be Joe, an old man on a little stool. The yoga studio used to be a butcher's. The bar with jars of M&Ms on the counter used to be a candy store. This park used to be a park. With crack vials and potholes on the running track. And dirt in the center of the field where grass should be. And that dog run was a field of geraniums. The Dominican restaurant used to be cheap, used to have a line out the door. I used to be able to afford to live above it and come down in the middle of the night and get half a chicken and a Heineken, especially after my girl left and I was tired staring at the linoleum and the sloping floors. The organic market used to be a sneaker store. Kim's Grocery used to sell 40s. The subway stop used to be dangerous. This coffee shop used to be a law office run by Mr. Jenkins. That sushi bar used to be the Jamaican spot. Those condos used to be a three-family house. I loved a woman who lived there. The barbershop used to be a papa's house and was once overrun by rats. We filled in the spaces between the steps leading down to what used to be the storage room but was your papa's floor. We clubbed the rats when we saw them. They screamed like children. The Thai joint used to be the OTB, and every morning Joe, the old man on the stool, walked there, bought coffee for 50 cents, placed $2 bets, went back to his stool, called out to me, "Hey, young fella," and told me how it used to be. Coffee used to be 50 cents. Nina? Cops used to be in squad cars. They weren't always so polite. Biggie used to freestyle over there on that corner, and Jay-Z came up right over there by Marcy, and Big Daddy Kane once played a block party here on Marcus Garvey, and your father used to be Slim and ran these courts on Macon and Malcolm X. He once almost dunked on a college prospect. The new Casablanca Bar and Lounge used to be for all black people. All black people used to be able to afford this corner. The garden used to be a drum circle before the new neighbors called the cops to complain. Stuyvesant Heights used to be Bed-Stuy. That family with the stroller used to be black. Those young people on the stoop over there used to be black and Puerto Rican and arrested. That school used to be public. This This used to be Brooklyn. This used to be Brooklyn. They used to be scared to come here. They used to be scared to come here. They used to be scared to come here. They used to be sorry for us. We had to live here. It was a look like pity, like scorn. It looked like this corner and these bricks. And this new Brooklyn was what they left when they ran. Brooklyn was what they left when they ran. Brooklyn was what they left when they ran. Brooklyn used to be black, Nina. I swear to you, this used to be Brooklyn! Doggy daycare used to sell dashikis. This bar used to be a flower shop. The artisanal coffee shop used to be Jollof restaurant. This used to be Brooklyn. This used to be Brooklyn. Being black means building a vocabulary for survival out of the rubble of language bequeathed us by colonialism and empire. It makes our tongues and hearts so shapeshift that nigger and God both mean love coming from our mouths. Homes, star, family, partner, my nigga, brethren, essay, fool, black, killer, dude, slim, local, cousin, captain, player, skipper, nigga, son, guard, blood, gangster, horse, man, homie, boy, dread, nigga, Taino, money, love, youngin, uncle, joke, friend, king, rasta, nephew, lord, boss, my nigga, 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 my nigga. Thank you. Uncle Joe, friend, nephew, king, lord, Rasta, fam, boss, brother, G, money, gangster, nigga, killer, star, family, God, 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 God. What it do, star? We're saying that say, well, I'm no dude, break yourself, nigga. What up, man? Stick him up, dread. Asalaamu Alaikum, nigga. Asalaamu Alaikum, love. Asalaamu Alaikum, friend. Asalaamu Alaikum, king. Asalaamu Alaikum, nephew. Asalaamu Alaikum, lord. Asalaamu Alaikum, brother. Asalaamu Alaikum, nigga. Nigga, 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 nigga. Who you love? What up? One love, Joe. You 5-0? You 5-0, Rasta? You 5-0, king? You 5-0, dread? You 5-0, dude? You 5-0, slim? You 5-0, player? You 5-0, god? God? Nigga, brethren, essay, fool, captain, son, horse, gangster, nigga, skipper, local, cuz break yourself, what it look like, holla, bless up, oh yeah, nigga, what up, king, what up, where you stay at, Joe, where you stay at, money, what you got, love, how much you want for that, love, how much you want for that, love, you got beef, nigga, you got beef, nigga, you got beef, nigga, you got beef, God, you got beef, God, you got beef, God, you got beef. Nephew, player, lord, god, captain, player, nigga, 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 god, 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 home, star, family, partner, my nigga, brethren, essay, fool, killer, captain, nigga, gangster, horse, boy, dread, money, love, where you stay at? Where you stay at, where you are, where you living, where you going, what you doing, who are you, who are you, who are you, who are you, nigga, who are you, God, 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 who are you, nigga, 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 God, 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 God.
Being black means building a vocabulary for survival out of the rubble of language bequeathed us by colonialism and empire. It makes our tongues and hearts so shapeshift that nigger and God both mean love coming from our mouths.
Citation. Maybe it was the absurd sight of a helmeted man pissing on a fence. Maybe that it was a fence separating the sidewalk from a playground. Maybe it was because it was 4 a.m. and everything wrong happens at 4 in the morning. Every dumb story, every fight that ended the night at the club when I was young and these streets not yet worth policing. But the bright-eyed, fresh cop boy sliding up to say, hey, buddy, must not recognize him twice his age or that I have my dick in my hand. Maybe he and his partner haven't yet processed the sleek, white-wheeled, bullhorn-handled bicycle leaned up next to me before he asks the next dumbass question. Didn't you see us there? And for 2 seconds, my drunk brain is aflight with all the unsmart things I want to say. Yeah, saw you. I wanted to show you my dick. No, I didn't, but I'm sure glad you're here now. Yeah, I actually was trying to piss on your shoes, but I'm too drunk to aim right. But only the self-preservation me speaks. But the pig won't relent. He's got a treasure trove of questions like these he saves for 4 a.m. for grown black men on Quincy Street, Bedford Stuyvesant, on the come-up hood type joint while he hoofs his beat. You couldn't hold it, huh? And I'm worried that there might be a little smile on my face now. 19-year-old wise-ass me showing up late with cocaine and tequila to mess the party up. And he and his partner are so not yet old enough to legally get the kind of drunk I am right now, but they're one thumb nonchalant in a belt, one hand casual on a service revolver type, sure of themselves. And the one barks something into his radio about how he could give me a much worse citation, but he let me get off easy, but you shouldn't pee in public, blah, blah, blah. Like I ain't been potty trained several years before his parents even thought to fuck each other. And the couple that passes by just then, not even noticing the commotion, shouldn't need to enter the poem, except just 10 years ago, the police wouldn't be walking the beat here, just cruising by in squad cars and asking my purple-haired combat boot girlfriend if she was sure she was in the right place. But tonight, that cop is just as sure the tittering blondes passing just behind him are safe because he's got this under control. And then, almost silently, a murmuring among them like a group of Jesuits on the way to mass, 10 more police show up, their shoes not making a sound, and they stand around while Babyface runs my ID, and I'm thinking that isn't it something? This is really how it's gonna go down, beat to death by cops in Bed-Stuy, or maybe my life saved by my bicycle helmet like everyone always says it would, and my little girl in her mother's belly still will never meet me. So I try to hold the gaze of the one black cop, a woman, young, hope she sees her brother standing here, or her man, or her father. But she looks everywhere except my face, and her thumb is tucked in her belt too, and her hand resting on the 9mm like an afterthought, all of them doing their jobs, polite and casual, in Bed-Stuy finally, to protect, to serve. Huddled around an engine, hood up in winter, hoods up. Low-voiced, dropping verse and chapter about pistons and crankshafts. Young brother inside takes the signal, hits the gas. Hoods up, low-voiced and dropping verse on the corner of Fulton and Klassen, hand claps. Young brother inside takes the signal, hits the gas. The cipher gets deeper, bass croaks from a throat on the corner of Fulton and Klassen, hands clap. Taxi screeches to a halt, soaker out the window like a flag, deep in a flatbush cipher. Bass croaks from a throat, U-turn, and the lyric inside is smooth negotiate, peace. Soak her out the window like a flag when we stroll no strun. Black soap, sugarcane, shea butter, ice gold and green. And the lyric outside is peace, a soothe negotiate to all the slick-handed, dapped-up sidewalk economies. Black soap, sugarcane, shea butter, this hat is how we shop for household items in Black Brooklyn from all the slick-handed, dapped-up sidewalk hustlers. Morning, Tanti. Brethren, wapen now. Love, cousin. It's how we greet our fam in Black Brooklyn. Interlope here and look my people in the eye. Learn morning, Tanti. Love, cousin. Wap now, brethren. Love languages that could free you from your skin. Interlope here and learn before you impose, fam. We built the beat you came here seeking. We built the beat, we built the beat, we built the beat you came here. Craft love languages that could free you from your skin. If you join in, if you join in, if you make yourself the not center one time, if you make yourself the not center one time. We built the heat you came here seeking. Pistons, crankshaft, manifold, its entire engine. Join in, And one time, make yourself the knot center. Huddle around, hoods up. Huddle around, hoods up. Nod your head, nod your head, nod your head. It's winter.
My first pans is not made from an oil drum like the grown-ups' pans were. We had practice pans made from tin,
painted gaudy red.
I learned that year's calypso on it before I had to be taught. I invented my own arrangement, taught it to everyone. I played a single tenor. I was seven.
I cannot remember any of the notes, but I remember my body
swaying behind the pan.
I played the hymns.
My hands were an intricate kata. I remember that.
I remember the ripe adolescent sweat of the director's daughter, the baby powder on her neck.
I invented my own arrangements of things, hymns, arias, calypsos, my becoming. My first pan made a silly descant of a noise, but I beat it into a swing. I beat it into a story I could believe. Here's the first chapter. Once upon a time, there was a boy. He was afraid of nothing. He believed himself invincible. This was not remarkable in this way of boys, but when he opened his mouth,
when he sang,
everyone knew
his lungs were made.
Ever arranger of pan is an Indian. This poem is about him, Jit Samaru of Sori village, Aruka, where the poet comes from. Aruka, that is Africa, that is through coastal fort, through boat, through fire, through sugarcane, through tambu bamboo and the lash, through never returning to the land again, through returning to the land again. Jit mother play a mean dolat, everybody know that. Jit is an Indian, everybody know that too. An Indian don't mess with Creole people business, which is to say not pan, not football, not Rasta, not Creole people children. All sorts of things. Right now, he's convinced he's inside the belly of his greatest work ever. Rum will do that. This matters because this is Chicago, far from Aruka, far from Jit's arrangement of Kitchener's classic game changer, Pan in A minor. The poet is writing this poem because Jit has Alzheimer's, and sometimes the poet forgets things. Jit on guitar pan, Girly on cowbell, Vidya on drums, Babulal on maracas, Sunilal on scratcher, the Samaru kids of Trinidad in the broadest sense. The poet knows the code, knows what it means to have six simultaneous melodies locked away forever. It is deep in the calypso, this burying of one's best clothes. It is deep in the calypso, this burying. It is deep in the calypso, it is deep, it is deep, it is deep in the calypso, this burying of one's best clothes. Jit is an Indian arranging pan. Jit sees pan invented and killed for. This too, how we bury our clothes, make sure nobody claim what we claim. Imagine Jit, all this music, six melodies at once dedicated to the same arrangement. Hear his voice, soft like a valley breeze, soft like a guitar pan when you rap your sticks right. Soft like he know he might not belong, but you know music is all he know. Music is a polyglot beauty, music is an indenture ship, and Jit, indentured to these polyrhythms in the complication of the Lupino Valley. The Samaru kids, no parang, which mean they know Caribbean and Indian Indian. They know how to resist power and how to resist family. Jit is an Indian, the greatest arranger ever. His clothes buried for the poet expatriate in 1987, last carnival before he left. Buried in pan in A minor, a Kitchener tune, which is to say a pan tune. Hear the length of the vowels he leaves for the wonderkind Indian, such that arrangement melody, second melody during first melody, third melody during second melody, fourth melody during third breakdown in the rhythm section, breakdown, breakdown, breakdown in the rhythm section, the guitar pan, the minor rising in the way the church feared it would. So they called it the devil, so they called it the devil, they called it the devil, they called it the devil. And there was the poet child in 1987, body a whiplash to an Indian composer, looking to make love to a fat-bottomed black woman later that night. And love is all he knows how to pronounce. But the poem is 2012, and the bar is called Revolution. And the poet is watching film of renegades pile melody after melody on top itself, and half expecting to see his 18-year-old self in the crowd because he was there. And this is how black men bury their clothes, by being there, by not having to rely on legacy, by hearing the chord change of the film and knowing the Indian's progression by heart. But he knows the progression because he was there, holding a woman, sweating to the music the Indian man arranged like a boss, and knowing, both of them, that there was no way he wasn't going to win that night before they made love in the science building, in the chem lab, on the long bench, bruising their knees. How you keep all that music in your head and not have it stolen eventually? Forget it. That's what you do. Forget Aruka. Forget Mommy on the Dolak. Forget St. Pius Boys Roman Catholic Primary School. Forget the float of cord from shaft to what might be called flat. If it weren't so beautiful and back, if it weren't so beautiful, so black, bury your clothes and the Hummingbird Medal and the honorary doctorate and the thick Indian mustache and Vidya on the drums and Babulal on the scratcher and Sunilal on the guitar pan. Poet is looking for himself on the film. This is a metaphor with which the poet is familiar. The poet is an immigrant, so he stays looking for himself in the year of his crossing, 1987, 1845, 1712. The poet claims the Indian arranger. The Indian claims Aruka, where the poet is from. It does not matter. Their clothes are buried. Their clothes are buried. Their clothes are buried. The poet forgets things. He relies on love to save them. Jit is locked away in several buildings and piled on memories and melodies. All this beef is real, and still, Jit is the greatest, and still, Jit is the greatest, Jit is the greatest, Jit is the greatest, Jit is the greatest, Jit, Jit, Jit is the greatest, Jit is the greatest. All this beef is real, but Jit is the greatest. Remember for him that his mother played a mean dolak, that he could arrange anyone's song, not just Kitchener's. When he's dead, bury all his clothes. Can't you see? Says the poet, fading, his memory and faith in love giving out finally. Can't you see? It's what he would have wanted. We'll be right back.
How you doing, DC? All right, we got two more for you. Yes, I know how to load a 9mm, a 44 revolver deck, safety off, I know. The djembe's goatskin, the trinote of drum-kissed fingertips. How to dance on the downbeat, make pesto from scratch. I know how to play chess, cricket, croquet. I know Mozart, Marley, I know Biggie. I was once called the most brilliant student in 10 years in my high school. I was the head prefect. I know how to weigh heroin, and I know a fairly detailed timeline of hip-hop history. Yes. I know women, how to make love, how to put my mouth to their centers and pray. I know hot sauce from scratch. I make rice and peas. And I know how to plant a backyard garden, my fingers in the cool, wet earth, to dig a hole with only a machete, and I know garlic on the blade to make the inflicted wound unhealable. How to throw a punch, build a kite from brown paper bed sheets and flour and water glue paste. I know how to tie a reef knot, a timber hitch, make a splint and recite the Boy Scout lore. The black boy knows how to drag race, how to swing a bat at a man's head and not feel anything. I know how my own blood tastes. I know how my woman's blood tastes. Yes, I know how to walk on Melrose Place, on Southside Chicago, in Brooklyn, and how to slow it down in Arouca or Kingston or Castries. I drink rum straight with no monkey face, and I have had to bathe a drunk friend. I know how to rehab my mother's tender and new replacement hip, how to talk her down from the days she is still the girl given up for adoption, remind her of all the people who remember her name. I have not always known that, or how to say I love you, but I know how to hold a newborn and how to care for the baby's mother. Yes, I've broken a bottle with all intention to confetti another man's flesh. I've hopped the turnstile, I've punched a man and dipped through the back door. I know what to say when I'm lying to a woman about another woman. I know what to say, and yes, I've driven 18 hours to see the woman I love, to tell her I'll be hers alone if she needs it. I've meant it, and I know how to call Kevin when she says no, and Patrick, and Maureen. I know how to want the hole in my heart removed.
I know how to want. I know how to speak to a cop with his hand on his gun, a stick-up kid with his hand on his gun, my man Luis with his hand on his gun. I know my hand, my gun. I know my hand, my gun. I know my heart. I know my hand, my gun, my heart at half-mast, daring a motherfucker. Move. Maybe I can garden again, wield machete and hoe bust through the earth that eventually forgives. A man is still most alive by the sweat his body can make of its own work until the self leaves the self assault, returning to the dirt. Maybe this is how to make the body study now, steady now, build a new discipline or retool an old one that can sustain the body, which houses the fickle brain and quiets the noisy and restless imps weaving the everlasting quilts of blood. Isn't it after all that the body knows itself and its limits after a night of dancing? Isn't the night closing in on the body at all times except when it moves to push its own dark walls back? Digger. Call me road grader, call me scout, call me he who makes a way, call me he who avoids the bullet, call me he who takes it, call me bulletproof, call me resurrect, call me never dead, call me greatest of all time, call me by my name, call me the weave pattern of resist itself, call me revolt, call me revolt, call me revolt. Someone is burning black churches. Someone is setting fire to blackness in the night and watching it be ash by morning. The most American thing we have learned is how to plunder and pretend our robbery was our victim's salvation. In the dream, I'm the man on the roadside too. Call me he who builds a church in the night. Call me he who sets it ablaze. The movement needs two kinds of soldier, builders and burners. Praise the hands that set the CDS alight. Praise the looters. Praise the man in the photo with the bandana mask. Praise the boy who returns the live tear gas to the bewildered police. Praise black bodies always running. Praise the dream defenders. Praise New York City. Praise Bree Newsom. Praise Ferguson and Los Angeles and Staten Island and Charleston and Baltimore. Praise the flag that is a burning corporation. Praise the black flag. Praise guns in the hood waiting to clap back at the right time. Praise the right time. It is the right time. We are the right time. How to make the body steady now, steady now, sturdy now, stealthy now, build with all the tools, be disciplined, disciple, decisive, deceptive, be sod turner, seed planter, path clearer, be the hand that knows to lift the bird's nest down before the blade meets the perfect arc, be the perfect arc in combat, be the body willing to burn, be the celebration dance. Be the muscles pushing themselves against the wall darkness. Be the night itself when the riders come. Be the blood, the vigor, the vigilance, the violence, the rigor, the regal, the rage, the garden, the Eden, the powerful, the evil, the growth, the knowledge, the place to return to. Be morning and the clear sky insisting. Begin again. Be the morning, even when yours is the finger on the trigger, the hand on the heavy hilt. The violence, the rigor, the regal, the rage, the garden, the Eden, the powerful, the evil, the place to return to, and these three things. Be alive, be black, burn, build. Be alive, be black, burn, build. Be alive,